As explained on the cover of the record album, this transcendental vibration by chanting of Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, is the sublime method for reviving our Krishna consciousness. As living spiritual soul, we are all originally Krishna conscious entities, but due to our association with matter from time immemorial, our consciousness is now polluted by material atmosphere. In this polluted concept of life, we are all trying to exploit the resources of material nature, but actually we are becoming more and more entangled in our complexities. This illusion is called Maya, our hard struggle for existence, for winning over the stringent laws of material nature. This illusory struggle against the material nature can at once be stopped by revival of our Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness is not an artificial imposition on the mind. This consciousness is the original energy of living entity. When we hear the transcendental vibration, this consciousness is revived, and the process is recommended by authorities for this age. By practical experience also, we can perceive that by chanting this Maha Mantra or the great chanting for deliverance, one can at once feel transcendental ecstasy from the spiritual stratum. When one is factually on the plane of spiritual understanding, surpassing the stages of sense, mind and intelligence, one is situated on transcendental plane. This chanting of Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, is directly enacted from the spiritual platform, surpassing all lower status of consciousness, namely sensual, mental and intellectual. There is no need of understanding the language of the mantra, nor there is any need of mental speculation, nor any intellectual adjustment for chanting this Maha Mantra. It springs automatically from the spiritual platform, and as such, anyone can take part in this transcendental sound vibration without any previous qualification and dance in ecstasy. We have seen it practically. Even a child can take part in the chanting, or even a dog can take part in it. The chanting should be heard, however, from the lips of a pure devotee of the Lord, so that immediate effect can be achieved. As far as possible, chanting from the lips of non-devotee should be avoided, as much as milk touched by the lips of a serpent causes poisonous effect. The word Hara is the form of addressing the energy of the Lord. Both Krishna and Rama are form of addressing directly the Lord, and they mean the highest pleasure eternal. Hara is the supreme pleasure potency of the Lord. This potency, when addressed as Hare, helps us in reaching the supreme law. The material energy, called as Maya, is also one of the multi-potencies of the Lord, as much as we are also marginal and potency of the Lord. The living entities are described as superior energy than matter. When the superior energy is in contact with the inferior energy, it becomes an incompatible situation. But when the supreme marginal potency is in contact with spiritual potency, Hara, it becomes the happy, normal condition of living entity. The three words, namely Hara, Krishna and Rama, are transcendental seeds of the Maha Mantra, and the chanting is spiritual call for the Lord and his internal energy, Hara, for giving protection to the conditioned soul. The chanting is exactly like genuine cry by the child for mother. Mother Hara helps in achieving the grace of the Supreme Father Hari for Krishna, and the Lord reveals himself to such sincere devotee. No other means, therefore, of spiritual realization is as effective in this age as chanting the Mahamantra Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Rama, Hare Hare.